In this lesson, we're going to look at analogue instruments, and by the end of it you should be able to see what an analogue instrument is and the two types of scales used for analogue instruments, and you should be able to also identify some analogue instruments. So what is an analogue instrument? An analogue instrument is anything that has a graduated scale on the device itself. So say for instance an old wristwatch, a clock, a ruler that's in your bags, or measuring tape, anything that has graduations or markings that list values on the instrument itself is an analogue instrument. So when I was talking about it, I said that it have to have graduations, scale graduations on the instrument itself. And what is a scale? A scale is just simply a range of values written on the instrument based on accurately known values for the quantity. And the scales can be either one of two things. It could either be a linear scale or a non-linear scale. And linear should be having you think about the word line or straight line. And I'll show you what I mean by straight line later on. A linear scale is evenly spaced between the graduations on the instrument. So it has even spacings. And another name for a linear scale is called a uniform scale. A non-linear scale has uneven spacings between the graduations of the instrument. Another name for the non-linear is called a non-uniform scale. When they say linear and I said you should associate it with lines, think about this. For every reading, let's say for every reading we increase a value, a count value, starting from 1, we go to 2, to go to 3, to go to 4. If for instance we are measuring meters, alright, we say we measure 1 meter, 2 meter, 3 meters. Notice that if we were to plot it on a graph of reading against value, we will see that these reading against value tend to form what we call a straight line or a linear line. That's why we call it linear. Whereas if you have something that is distributed unevenly, let's say for instance the volume in a conical flask, notice that the volume in a conical flask for each reading, the distances between the graduations tend to increase. So while it may be close at the bottom of it, as you keep going higher and higher on the graduations for a conical flask, you would notice that the distances tend to spread out. And even though you may have uniform values for the count, so this here is the count, right? So reading 1, reading 2, reading 3, notice that from each one the graph will tend to start curving upwards like that. And that is a non-linear graph. So you could actually see the difference between the two and understand why one is called a linear or uniform and why one is called a non-linear or non-uniform scale. When you're looking at some of the instruments that some of the quantities that we talked about before, which is length and time, we see that there are a couple of instruments that you could use. For instance, length, you can say use a measuring tape, or you can use vernier calipers and micrometer screw gauge. The little asterisk on the side of the micrometer and the vernier is simply to make sure that you try and know about these devices in particular. These devices are often very tricky to read, and I would recommend that you go and look for a video on YouTube or do some research and find out how to read them. Because when you are using them for experiments in school, you would need to know how to read the values from the vernier caliper. If it is, even if your teacher does not explain how to do it, you should know how to do it because you are supposed to prep for your lab. And this is one of the things that you have to prep to learn to use. Another instrument that we look at, quantity that we look at is time, and the instrument used to measure time is a clock. You can also use a stopwatch or a timer. So if it is that you have any questions for me or any comments, you can leave it with the video or you can send me a message. Thank you for watching.